Today on Making It Home, I'm going to show you how I built this awesome adjustable width tool charging station. Before I cut any pieces for this project, I designed the whole thing in Fusion 360. I wanted to make sure the whole thing worked out the way I had it visioned in my head. I started with the tool supports and made sure that these fit all the tools I had. I designed the width of these pieces so that I knew the widest and the narrowest tools I had would work well. Next, I added additional tool supports, and then I added the back piece that all supports rest on. This included the Craig Mini Track system so I could adjust the width of all the tool holders. I also created a battery charger and battery holding area above the tools. And then to hang both of these on the wall, I added cleats on the back. The cleat system allows me to move this around on the wall without having to drill any additional holes. With everything designed, I started cutting out the parts. I started out the project by cutting out some of the tool hanger parts on the CNC machine. This really saved a lot of time during the build since there are a lot of repetitive cuts to make. I did put tabs on all the parts cut out by the CNC machine, so I had to trim those out later. If you don't have a CNC machine, you can cut all of the tool hanger parts by hand. I started by cutting some strips on the table saw, then cutting those to length, and then I cut out one piece which I used as a template for all the other pieces. Next, I spent time on the table saw cutting out most of the pieces of plywood for the project. This saved a lot of setup time and it made sure that a lot of the parts were the exact same width or length. The first thing I started assembling was the back piece on the tool hangers. I started from the top of the piece and adding the plywood, then the Craig Mini Track, then more plywood, and so on. Just take your time and make sure the spacing is correct. After you get everything glued together, you can run it through the table saw one last time to cut the excess off the bottom. This will make sure that you have no overlap on the top or bottom piece. Next, I just added some glue to the French cleat and screwed it onto the back. Next, it was time to work on all of the tool hangers. I started by drilling and countersinking the two holes in the top pieces. Then it was time for a lot of sanding. And I mean a lot of sanding. And because I had rounded over some of the edges, this took a little longer than expected. It was certainly worth it because the rounded edges certainly help with the tool sliding in and out. The next step was to drill the 1/4-inch holes through the tool hangers. I drilled the 1/4-inch holes through the pieces from the back so that I knew the spacing was exactly 6 inches to match up with the mini track. The holes can be a little bit off on the front. That really doesn't matter. One of the things I didn't think about was that by using the CNC, I had some small radiuses on the insides of some of the corners, so I had to take these off at the bandsaw. This also included the inside of the slot in the top piece of the tool hangers. You need to take off just enough of that inside slot so that the vertical piece of the tool hanger slides up and down freely. At this point, I actually took out the shorter screws that were in the top piece of track and put in longer screws. I knew the top track was going to take a lot more stress as the tool hangers would try to pull it off the wall. Oh yeah, and then there was more sanding. Did I mention there was more sanding? Yeah, there was more sanding. So finally it was time for some finish on the tool hanger. I used just a simple Minwax wipe-on polyurethane. I definitely wanted to use a wipe-on finish since the tool holder pieces were all such weird shapes. And I should mention that I finished them individually and then I screwed them together. I ended up putting 3 coats of wipe-on finish on the tool holder since they're going to get a lot of abuse. After the final finish coat, I used a brown paper bag just to rub down the surface. So now it was time to put all the tool hangers together and really see if this thing would hold tools like I had planned. Before I had finished the pieces, I had pre-drilled the holes from the top piece through to the bottom piece, and I made sure all of these parts were matched up. You can actually see that I numbered them all individually. This really helped all the parts fit together perfectly, and it accounted for any little changes in the way I drilled through the pieces. Once those parts are screwed together, now we need to add the hanger bolts. So these can be a little snug, since there might be a little finish that worked its way into the holes, so you might have to push on those a little bit. Next, we add a flat washer and a lock washer to each of these bolts. The lock washer is going to help hold things in place. You can certainly put on just a regular hex head nut, but I decided to go with wing nuts so you could do some really quick adjustments on the tool spacing. So I just went through and added all of this hardware onto each of the hanger pieces, and then I hung them all up at the same time. The hex heads on the quarter inch bolts are really a tight fit on the Craig Mini Track, which really helps them tighten up well, but you need to make sure the bolt heads are aligned as you slide these on the track. I actually ended up making two of these tool hangers, and you'll see that that gave me a lot of extra storage. At first I thought it was overkill, but I ended up filling it up pretty fast. Okay, here it is. I've got the tool holder on the wall. Actually, I've got a 30 inch section here, and then I've got a second 30 inch section on the left side. So the nice thing about this system is, if you build one and you want to expand it, make it wider, you can add another section, and then the tool holders will actually go in between because the tracks line up. So, and not only that, but you can have a tool holder on one of these and another one on the other, and you can actually hang a tool in between because they will not slide apart. So now I'm gonna go through and show you how to add the tools and set the spacing. To get started, just pick one of the sides of the tool hanger and lock that tool hanger in place. Once you get that set, just grab whichever tool you want to put up first, hold it into position, and slide the second tool hanger up against it. Next, just gently slide the tool out and then tighten the wing nuts, starting with the bottom and then go to the top. I found out really fast that it was easier just to lightly tighten the wing nuts, check the tool one more time, and then tighten them up the rest of the way. As you've probably guessed by now, the beauty of this system is that you can easily change tools out and not have to worry about cutting new parts for the tool hangers. You just loosen the wing nuts, slide the tool holder where you want it to go, and tighten it back up. I think a lot of people overlook the fact that you can take something like the Craig Mini Track and turn it into a permanent part of a piece of furniture instead of just using it for things like jigs. In this case, it adds some incredible flexibility to the tool hanger system. And if you weren't aware, you can actually cut the aluminum track using your miter saw or your table saw. Just make sure if you have something like a saw stop that you turn off the flesh sensing technology so you don't accidentally trigger the brake. So with the tool hanging portion of this project done, now we're going to work on the tool charging portion, which is the box that hangs above the tools. This is just a simple box that's put together with pocket holes. You'll notice in the video that I went a little overboard on the number of pocket holes I put in the back of this box. I kind of forgot how strong they actually are. If I was going to build this again, I would use quite a few less. But hey, on the bright side, this thing is not going to fall apart. So I got a little ahead of myself putting these boxes together, and I had cut all the pocket holes in the back, and that was great. And what I meant to do was put the pocket holes in the top and bottom before I glued it together. So the nice thing about pocket holes is at least you can still cut them when you have a box of a certain size. So all I have to do really is set this up so I can put it in the pocket hole jig already partially assembled. So, you know, live and learn. Well, thank goodness you can actually add pocket holes to something that's partially assembled. I drilled all the pocket holes in the top and bottom of the box, and then I screwed it all together with some glue. With the top, bottom, and back pieces now together, I could take a final measurement and cut the side pieces. Next, I added some glue and some clamps, and I screwed both ends on the box. Yes, I know, it's still a lot of pocket holes. I get it. After a light sanding on the back of the box, I added some glue and the French cleat so I could hang it from the wall. You'll notice that the French cleat actually covers part of the top row of pocket holes. That's not really a big deal since we're not going to take those out anyway. And with the boxes assembled, I could put them on the wall and try them out. I have to admit, I was pretty excited to be able to put all the chargers and batteries up in these boxes and clear those off of the work area down below. Oh yeah! All of the other times I've used pocket holes, I've always had those in hidden locations, but since I didn't on this, I decided to fill those holes with some 3/8 inch dowels. Once the glue dried, I used a flush trim saw to cut them off. Then it was time for a little more sanding to get those plugs nice and smooth. So at this point, the plywood box is basically done. You could hang this on the wall and use it just fine the way it is. I decided to kind of hide this plywood edge by taking some thin strips of maple and gluing it in place. The piece on the bottom on the front is actually 3/4 inch taller than the other pieces so that it gives me that extra lip to help hold things in place. Once I added the trim and some finish, it was time to put these things up on the wall. I found some really great outlet strips to use when charging batteries. These things actually have a switch for each outlet, so I can turn chargers on and off as I want. That means I'm not plugging and unplugging chargers all the time. I also found some sweet little LED light strips to put on the bottom of the tool charger so I can light up the work area down below. All right, that's a wrap on the tool charging station. I'm really happy with how it turned out. Now I can adjust the width of these tool holders easily. Make sure you subscribe. We're gonna be putting a lot of other things on the wall out here. And while you're waiting for the new videos to come out, you can check out some of our older ones as well. Thanks for watching.